Hello everyone, in this session I'll be discussing about human values. To start off, we first should know about the concept of value. Value term was initially used in economics, and we all know that value here means benefit, whatever benefit we can draw from a particular thing. More benefit, more the value of the thing. Initially, anything that satisfied a human need became a thing of value. But in this definition, social approval was lacking. So later on, it was modified to include social approval, and it became like anything which is socially desired and leads to satisfaction of human needs becomes a thing of value. So here we have two components of value. One is satisfaction and second is desirability. It means the thing which satisfies the needs of an individual and which is desirable for the society also is valuable. Philosophers defined it as a belief shared by the members of a culture regarding what is good or bad, acceptable or non-acceptable. Values govern human behavior or action, because whatever values we carry, we behave according to that. Now, coming to the Indian philosophy, the term value has been recorded back in the ancient history. Value term is so old as our history is. So, in that terms, in Indian philosophy or in Indian history, Purusharth was the term used for the values which human being should seek. And there are four values which a human being should seek, and in a hierarchy, these are like Arth, Kam, Dharma and Moksha. Arth means the economic value or the wealth the person works to earn money. And the purpose to earn money is to gain pleasure. That is the second level of need. Then the third level of value comes is dharma, means the right and wrong definition of right and wrong, means the righteous path we have to choose to achieve a particular thing, and the moral values which we follow. Ultimately, by following dharma, we achieve moksha, that is the param purusharth, means the spiritual freedom and self-perfection. It leads to liberation of a human being from web of maya, or freedom from cycle of birth and death. So ultimately we can say that dharma leads to moksha. In absence of dharma, arth and kama are not good. Dharma in progression leads to moksha. These are the four stages, that is arth, kama, dharma and finally the moksha, the ultimate aim in life. Now if we see the Western philosophy, the universal values provided by the Western philosophy are truth, beauty, goodness and self-realization. Self-realization is nothing else, it is moksha itself. And if we talk about truth, beauty and goodness, it is the same we say in quote Satyam Shivam Sundaram. So we can say that the Indian and Western philosophy are correlated. Now the definition of value given by given in the International Encyclopedia of Social Sciences. Value is defined as a set of principles whereby conduct is directed and regulated as a guide for individuals and a social group. So, values are the principles which direct or govern our behavior, and it is the definition of right and wrong in a particular social group. Now, we come to the types of values. There are various types of values on different bases. So, the first base is the difference between values is on the basis of instrumental or intrinsic values. Instrumental values are those values which lead to achievement of the ultimate aim in the life. Like for example, Arth and Dharma are the instrumental values, because Arth leads to Kam and Dharma leads to Moksha. Intrinsic values are the end in itself. Instrumental values, which we discussed here, leads to achievement of intrinsic values. So in this sense, Arth leads to Kama, so Kama is intrinsic value, and Dharma leads to Moksha, so Moksha is the intrinsic value. Now coming to the second classification, which we have already discussed, that is the Indian traditional value classification, Arth, Kama, Dharma and Moksha. Third classification is according to the constitution. Our constitution says, the preamble of the constitution is like this: we the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic, and to secure to all its citizens justice, which is social, economic and political justice, liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith and worship, equality, of status and opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. In our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, we do hereby adopt, enact and give to ourselves this constitution. So this preamble very clearly depicts the values which our constitution has, that is, it is sovereign, it is socialist, it is secular, it is democratic republic. So on the basis of this, this is the actual picture of the preamble of our constitution. On the basis of our constitution, we have these three types of values. Democratic values means the freedom of thought, expression and belief. Equality and dignity of individuals, ensuring justice. Because in democracy, we all are involved in the decision making. Everybody has a say. So we have full freedom and equality in the government. Second is the socialist values. Socialist values like equality of status and opportunity, equitable distribution of wealth, because here government takes the responsibility for the social welfare of the country and equitable distribution of the wealth. Then finally, the secular values, because we are multi-religion country, so we are secular. We respect all religions and we have freedom of faith and worship. We can choose any religion, we can worship any god, so we are having secular values also. So on the basis of constitution, these are the three types of values. Coming to the next classification, that is the modern classification of values. The first is primary value or the organic values. These are the basic values which are required for the basic survival of an individual, for example, good food, drink, clothes, etc. Then comes the pleasure values or hedonistic values. Pleasure values, desire for pleasure and avoiding pains. Everybody wants to earn money to get pleasure. Then the third ones are the aesthetic values. The people who have high aesthetic values, they recognize beauty of nature and appreciate things which give joy of beauty. For example, fine arts, dance, music, poetry, any form of art. Then comes the economic values. The people who are having high economic values, they have high desire for money and materialism. Then comes the personal values. Personal values are the values which a person desires for his own. For example, somebody may want recreation, somebody may want knowledge, somebody can have quest for creativity. So everybody has different values. Then comes the family values. Family values are drawn due to the family culture or the family traditions. So the all members of the family shares certain common family values, like traditional values including faith, occupation, characteristics of caste and behavior in according to the family status. Then come the social values, because we belong to a particular society, so a particular social group shares certain social values. So these are desired together by a social group. Then comes the power values. The people who are having high power value, they desire to rule over others or lead others. Then are the intellectual values. The people who have high intellectual values, they love to gain knowledge. They have zest to discover and inclination toward truth. Then are the religious values. Religious values are the values where one has a faith in God, or they offer prayers, they do charity and they obey ethical codes of a religion. All these come under religious values. There are the moral values. These are the definition of rights and wrongs in a particular society. Dharma talks about this, and moral values of Indian culture are depicted in certain quotes like Satyam Shivam Sundaram, we already discussed. Then the Vasudev Kutumbakam means the whole earth is like a family. Then the last one is the spiritual values, the ultimate aim in the life, which is moksha or the self-realization. For this, one need to get detached. It inspires us and makes us free from all selfish actions. When we don't think about our selfish motives, we think about the welfare of everyone. This is the comparison of traditional versus modern values. We can clearly see that traditional values are related with the modern values. Earth means the economic value. Kama means the primary, hedonistic, aesthetic and recreational values. Dharma is related with moral, personal, social and intellectual values. And moksha is nothing else is the spiritual value. This comparison was done by Karen, 1996. So, last one, the types of values according to Gawande, the classification of values like this. he classified values among human values, national or constitutional values, social values, vocational or professional values, religious and aesthetic values. So the human values are the core values which are common in human beings without any discrimination on the basis of caste, religion or gender. And around these human values, all other values are built. National constitutional values are those values which the constitution of that particular nation provides to its citizens. Social values are for a particular social group. For example, values of Indian culture are respect and love for others, brotherhood, self-sacrifice and self-realization. Vocational or professional values belong to a particular profession. Like, for example, doctors have certain professional values. Similarly, lawyers have some different professional values. Then comes the religious values. These are common to the members of a particular religious group. If we belong to a particular religion, we have certain values which need to be followed as per that religion. And last comes the aesthetic values related to the beauty of nature, art, and all that. So with this, the types of values and the concept of values over. In the next session, we'll discuss about what are human values and what is the importance of human values in life. Thank you very much.